So hopefully now we have a really solid foundational understanding of what a method is and how it works. And with that knowledge, we can then go in and as we're writing our programs, we can break the program out into different methods that accomplish certain tasks, and that keeps it better organized, and allows us to reuse methods or functions over and over again by calling a method. It really is useful. The other part of it is that anytime we run into a problem where we think, oh man, I want to calculate the, arctangent or something like that, rather than trying to go out and do it on your own, chances are in many cases for kind of common things like that that people might want to do, there's already been a class that's been written out there. And there are thousands of pre-built classes and methods available to us to accomplish certain tasks. And so we won't even get close to looking at all of those. We'll just look at a few different ones as kind of examples, and then just know if you're running into those problems, it's good to go out and kind of do a search first to see what's available so that we don't have to reinvent the wheel. As fun as that would be to go in and write those programs to calculate the arctangent, if we're in a hurry and if there's a good solution available, that's a lot of times a better way to go. So let's just take a look first at the math class because there's a lot of math functionality that has been written already in the math class. So I'm going to go ahead and pull up a new Java program. Public class math fun. And then just to give you a feel for it, because we're not even going to talk about a small portion of the methods that are available out there, even in the math class. But if I just go out and pull up a browser and I say Java math class, then the first thing that comes up is this link from Oracle, who is currently housing Java. And if I click on this, it'll show me the details of the math class. So this is the math class. And then it tells me there's a couple of fields that we'll talk about as we get into objects, but then there's all these different methods available to us. So if I want to calculate the arctangent, there is a method called ATAN that does that I can call as part of the math class. If I click on this, it'll give me what the signature of that looks like. So we're passing in a double that it's going to refer to as A, and it returns a double, and it's going to return the arctangent of a value. The returned angle is in the range negative pi halves through pi halves. Special cases, if the argument is not a number, then the result is going to be not a number. If the argument is a zero, then the result is a zero with the same sign as the argument. And so there is a description of how this method, in essence, this is an instruction manual. We call this API. It's an instruction manual that tells us how to use this code. And so if we look at all of the methods that are available to us, there are a lot of methods that do different things. There's the PAL method that we took a look at. There's a random method that'll give us a random number. And so as we look at these, now let's use an example of a rounding, okay? So there's a round method. There's actually two of them, one that uses a double and one that uses a float. Well, how do I tell it to use a double or a float? Well, whichever one I pass in is what I'm going to get out, right? And what it's going to return is the closest long to that argument. So let's take a look at this and just try it. So let's get some division. So I'm going to do a double, just call it x, and set it equal to some ugly division, okay? Well, I'll just set equal to zero at first, and then we'll come in and do the ugly division. So we'll say x equals, and then let's get a number that's not going to divide even close to evenly. So let's do 13 divided by, I don't know what, I probably need a bigger number. 7. Let's see how this looks. Okay, system.out.println. I don't think it's going to be as ugly as I wanted it to be. And I'll just print out whatever's in X. Save that. Oh, did we already do a math fun? Let's cancel this for a second. We've already had fun with math. So this is the math class fun. So now I get a 1. Oh, that's because I'm doing the division with integers. See, I was trying to prove this lesson to you. If we take an integer and divide it by an integer, it's going to give us the result as an integer, and that's what it will set as the outcome. So let me do, let me do 13.3 divided by 7.8. How about that? Space this out so it's a little clearer. Okay, so 13.3 divided by 7.8, and I get this big, ugly number that I was looking for. Okay, well, I can take and say, instead of getting that big, ugly number, I want to do a math.round. Okay, so math is the class, right? And round is the method in the class. We're going to pass it a double. It's going to return us a long. And now that rounds up to a 2. So before we did that, I'll do it this way. What's the easiest way to do that? So let me just take that out. So before I did that, notice it was a 1.7051, and if I add that math, round back in, then I'm going to get a 2. I'm passing it this number that was the result of this formula, and it's giving back to me a 2, which is then stored in that variable. Okay, so that's the round. Let's check out the random class. Let's just do a random. So I'm going to get rid of this. Well, I'm going to set x equal to the math class dot random. Okay. The random is the method. And if I click on the method, notice I don't need to pass anything into it, but it's going to return a double value with a positive sign greater than or equal to 0 and less than 1. So this is a different way of getting a random number. So it gives me a 0.8167201169. So it gives me this crazy random number between 0 and 1, and then I can take that number and do something with it. So if I want to get a random number out of 10, then I can multiply this by 10. Whoops. Multiply this by 10 and then see what that looks like. Well, it's just going to be a number 6.8, but if I want to make it a random number, now I can round that. Okay, now how can I round it? Well, there's two ways. I can either come down here and say math.round the x. Okay, and that way it'll print a random number. Well, that didn't work so well, did it? Oh, well, that's fine what I did, but it's not doing anything. I'm not setting it anywhere. So then I'd have to say x equals math dot round x. So that would actually round it. So now I get a 4, 5, 8, 4. So I'm getting a number now be through 0 and 10, I think. Or sorry, 0 through 9, I guess is what I was thinking. The other thing we can do here is put the math.round and pass it the random number that we're creating at the same time. So this is totally legal to take one method and pass it the result of another method, because it ends up just being a number in the end, right? What comes out of this is just a number, and then we multiply it by this number, and this whole thing is a number that we then pass into the round, and this should work essentially the same way. Oh, we do get a 10, so do we ever get a 0? Well, That was nice of fate to put a 0 right there, right when I ran it. So this will give us a number between 0 and 10. So we have to, if we wanted it between 1 and 10, then what would we do then? Well, we'd have to take at the end of all of this and add a 1 onto it, and then instead of doing 0 through 10, we'd do 0 through 9. Now we'll get a 1 through a 10, right? Because we'll get a 0 through a 9, and then we add 1 to it. So we should be able to get, if we run this enough times, there's a 10, and now we should get a 1 without getting any zeros. This is some great television. This is what you always wanted to watch, was me clicking this button over and over and over again. I can't get a 1. Come on, random. Give me that 1 I want. Oh, there's a 2. We were close. There we go. There was the 1. Okay. So back to the methods. There are a lot of methods. There's a floor method. The floor method, if we click on it, we pass in a double, we get back a double. This returns the largest, closest to positive infinity, double value that is less than or equal to the argument and is equal to the mathematical integer. So we can say, what's the floor of that number, which will take us down to the next integer, right? So the floor, so if we go back in and get our ugly number again, x equals, what was it, 13.3 divided by 7.8, something like that. Did we get an ugly number there? So 1.7 is what that gives us. That's, I think that was the right number. If I take and set x then equal to the math dot floor of x, then that will take me down to the next integer. So because I was at a 1.7, this should take me down to a 1. And it does. If I run it again, it should do the same thing. There's also a ceiling method, C-E-I-L. This returns the value that is the top of the integer, right? I can go to the ceiling. So floor and ceiling, this should give me a 2, and it does. Okay. So there's lots of useful methods that are available to us. I won't, again, not going to go through all of them, but some that we use quite frequently is the square root. SQRT is the square root method. And we pass in a double, and it will give us the square root as a result. I just saw another one that I thought would be helpful. Oh, hypotenuse. So we can calculate the hypotenuse, right? Anyway, lots of different useful methods that somebody has gone out and written for us, or a team of people. I'm not exactly sure how it came to be. But have put all of these useful formulas into one class called the math class. And in this case, we're just going to refer to the math class. So we say math dot, and then the method. So the method belongs to the math class, and then in the parentheses we pass what it is we want to use to do something with, and then we get that result. And that's kind of how methods work. So hopefully that's helpful to kind of take a look at one math class. We may take a look at one or two more just to give as examples, but know that there are many, many, many methods out there. And many classes with methods in them, I guess I should say, out there. All right. Okay. Spencer out.